Hey, here we go again. Hello YouTube. How are you doing, guys? Today we are gonna do a fabric material. Let's get started. Blender already opened. I think about doing like a bed, let's say. So I'm gonna scale this cube. We are not gonna delete it. You are safe for the moment. Okay, let's go with a thickness of 0.06, just like that. X-axis is gonna be 2.5, let's say, and y-axis 1.6, so it's a pretty much real scale of a bed. I'm gonna bring it up more. Let's go into edit mode. I'm gonna put two edge loops. Let's scale them on x-axis until this point, let's say. Two edge loops on the other side also, just like that. Scale on y-axis until here, let's say. Now I'm gonna press 3 so I can go into polygon edit mode, and I'm gonna select these polygons that I've just created. Let me get on the side view, just like that. Extrude, and that's the plate of the bed, just like that. Maybe we can do something more, like extruding also this part, just like that, let's see. So for the moment everything is fine. I'm gonna select this polygon, Shift D, then P to separate the selection. I'm gonna get into edit mode. Let's select these edges, just like that. Scale on y-axis until this part. Then I'm gonna move on x-axis this part, and extrude 0.29. Seems like a real mattress thickness. Let's add a bevel modifier, just like that. Maybe that's too much of a bevel, so this should be fine. Just like that. Maybe I'm gonna apply the modifier. Now let's get the cloth. So I'm gonna bring a plane. Let's bring it more up, just like that. I'm gonna go into edit mode. Let's move this until this point. Maybe I'm gonna make the sides also much more bigger, just like that. Now I'm gonna put an edge loop somewhere around here, just like that. Let's move this part until here, let's say. Then I'm gonna add another edge loop around this area, and I'm gonna move it a little bit on x-axis, just like that. Now if we are gonna apply the cloth modifier with this much geometry, it's not gonna look so great. So I'm gonna add some edge loops, let's say something like that should be fine. I'm gonna add one edge loop around here. Let's go with 3 here and 16 here, just like that. So for the moment we solved this part. Now if I'm going into this panel, which is a physics property, and I am applying the cloth modifier, just like that, we can take a look. If we are playing, nothing is happening for the moment, only the plane is falling, and that's because we are not having any collision set to the other objects, so I'm gonna put a collision modifier to the mattress, a collision modifier also to the bed, and now let's play. So that's the result. Now the things are looking pretty strange here. Let me add a solidify modifier so we can see better what's happening. Okay, solidify modifier. Things are looking good for the settings. Now as we can see, it's getting into itself, the mesh. So we can check, 1 second, collision, just like that, self-collision. So that's gonna prevent the mesh into falling in itself. As we can see, we are having a little bit of space in here, but maybe that's too much. We can go with a lower value, something like that, maybe a little bit less, let's say 0.006, and that's perfect. Now maybe I will select the whole mesh. Let's go to polygons, select everything, and then subdivide. So now we are having much more geometry, just like that. And maybe I'm gonna adjust some things. I'm gonna turn on proportional editing, and then let's see. I'm gonna move this here, then I'm gonna go like that. Let's also move this part. Too much. Something like that. Let's also shade it smooth. And now if we are playing, we are having many details visible. I can also put a subdivide modifier, and we need to make sure that the subdivide modifier is after the cloth modifier, because if we are putting the subdivide modifier first and then the cloth, that's gonna calculate how the cloth is gonna act for every single polygon, also with the subdivide modifier taking it into account. So that's gonna run much more slower. So for the moment we are having our cloth. Let's go to materials. I'm gonna add a new material. Okay, so just like that, now we can look into the material. For the moment we are having the principal BSDF material. That's fine. I'm gonna go to texture, then let's bring in wave texture. We are gonna take a look into it. I'm gonna press Ctrl T, then move it into UV. That's gonna follow better the geometry, and I'm gonna hit unwrap just like that. And because I entered in edit mode, it changed the position of the cloth. Let's say something like that. It's fine, so it's pretty good. Now we are having some results here. Everything is fine. Let me move this a little bit further away. Now I will leave the settings here like that. I'm gonna add a little bit of distortion. Let's say a value of 3.3, it's fine. I'm gonna add a color ramp, so I can get the things a little bit more harder, just like that. And I'm gonna get a bigger value, let's say 300, so the lines are much more smaller, just like that. Now I'm gonna copy those two nodes, Shift D, and then I will change it to y-axis. Let's also plug the mapping vector, just like that, and then I will press Ctrl and Shift. I will hold them, then right click. That's gonna bring a mix node, so with that we can switch in between them, but a value of 0.5, it's pretty fine. So it's gonna take from both of the parts, and we are gonna get this kind of crisscross. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. Let's move it a little bit further away. I'm gonna plug it into the base color so we can take a look in here, and we can change some settings here, like if we are enabling sheen, that's like imitating the effect of fabric. And we are gonna also need some colors. Now for the colors of the cloth, we can go with a lot of ways. Like maybe you want one single color, then you are gonna plug the mix node from here into color one, then we are gonna get a color here, and if we are changing it to multiply, that's how it's acting, just like that. But let's say we need a pattern, then we are gonna bring a checker texture. Let's look at it. Now I'm gonna leave it just like that for the moment, and also I'm gonna plug the vector from here into the vector of the checker texture, just like that. Let's get the scale a little bit bigger, let's say 50. That's pretty fine. Then I'm gonna duplicate it. I'm gonna hold again Ctrl then Shift and right click to mix it. But let's take a look first off. I'm gonna put Ctrl T, change it to UV. And the reason I'm doing that, it's I will move this just a little bit. Let's take a look into the mix, just like that. 0.5, like this. I'm gonna change also the x-axis, just like that. So now we are having much more colors. Maybe the pattern it's a little bit too big. Let's go for 10 with 10, just like that. But now we need to change the measurements. 5 and 5. Okay, that's pretty good. But we are still not having colors. And we can solve that by adding a color ramp. Then I'm gonna change it to constant. And now if we take a look, we are having much more colors. Let's see, we are having three kind of colors. So that's gonna be, let's say, blue, then we are having white. I'm gonna try to make them pretty much equal. Let's just take a look. So now we are having a pattern here. Let's maybe change the colors here. So that's gonna be a lighter blue, just like that. White, let's make it also another kind of blue, less saturated, just like that. So now, instead of using the checker texture, and we are gonna have only two colors, we brought three colors into the pattern. So now I'm gonna plug this into here, and it's all set. Let's take a look into the principal BSDF, just like that. So everything is looking fine. I'm gonna take this node and I'm gonna plug it into the roughness, but it's reflecting too much. So I'm gonna take another color ramp and I'm gonna change a little bit the values here. Like for the black part, that's meaning zero roughness, but we do not want that for a cloth. So let's say we are gonna go with 0.55, just like that. So this is looking pretty good. Now I'm gonna take once more the node from the mix node, and I'm gonna plug it into the normal value, but we need a bump node, and I'm gonna plug that into height. We are having also a node input for normal, but we need a normal map. We cannot use a black and white map. We are needing an XYZ map, something like that, which is calculated by the normals. And now if we are taking a look, we are getting also the illusion of depth into the cloth. And we can also add some more details into the cloth. Let me just duplicate the bump map. Now the second bump node is gonna plug into normal, because if we are taking a look, now we are having that data that we were needing, this kind of a map. That's what the bump node is doing. It's converting black and white values to normal. And let's move a little bit the things around here. I need some more space, just like that. And let's bring a noise texture, just like that. Let's take a look into it, something like that. And this can be plugged into the bump. If we are taking a look, now we are having also the data from the mix node, and also the data from the normal, from the noise texture, sorry. But that's a little bit too much. If we are adjusting the strength value, it's affecting only the height value, not the normal value. If we want to change the normal value, then we need to change the distance, but that's fine for the moment. So let's say I am for the things to be visible, I'm gonna let it to a value of 0.4 for the moment. So let's get it a little bit smaller, maybe much more details, just like that. We can take a look into it. So now we can see a difference. The cloth, it's not so smooth like before. Let's take a look. So that's how it's looking without any noise. It's too smooth. Now we are having some much more break into the surface. It's not perfectly smooth, but maybe the strength it's too much. So I'm gonna go with a value of 0.2, just something small, maybe a little bit more, 0.3, just like that. So it's a subtle change also, just like that. Let's just get the screen bigger. Maybe I'm gonna render also, so we can take a final look, just like that. And let's change the number of maximum samples. 256, light F, full global illumination, and let's render. So that's the result. As we can see, we are having also the noise texture into here, so it can be visible from a close view, and we can also see that pattern. The thing with this pattern, maybe it's too big. You do not want to be this visible, and this can be done. Let's go back into shading. This can be solved if we are going back into the wave textures. We can play with the scale from here. So let's say I'm gonna go with 500, but we need to change the value for both of the nodes. We can do that by in this way, or by going to input, taking a node, a value node, and plug it into the scale from the first wave texture and the scale of the second wave texture. And now if I put 500 here, it's gonna adjust both of the nodes. As we may look, let's try a scale of five, just like that. So they are both adjusting. Well, that's too small. It's just for the sake of the example. So let's go back to 500, just like that. Things are looking great. So I'm gonna save. Let's get the camera bigger. Now guys, I hope you like the video and learn something new in this tutorial. It's gonna be so helpful for me if you like the video and subscribe to the channel. And if you are having any questions, guys, just leave a comment and I will answer to it as fast as I can. The model is gonna be available on my Patreon page, where you can also see the clips earlier if you subscribe, and also your name is gonna be in the clips. Now, thank you for watching, and see you into the next one. Bye.